So I'm going to talk on diseases and computer molds of mushrooms. There are a number of diseases of mushroom crops, and among those diseases, fungal diseases are very serious as compared to your viral and bacterial diseases of mushrooms. Mushroom diseases, they can cause complete crop failure and 100% disease crop loss to the growers. In India, there are very limited options for the management of mushroom diseases are available. And as far as the chemical control of mushroom diseases are concerned, none of the pesticide have level claim. And whatever pesticide we are using in India till date, they are used in European country or elsewhere for the management of mushroom diseases. Among the chemical options, we have 10 important chemicals which we are using for the management of mushroom diseases. Among those, like your iperidione, prochloraz, carbendazim, thiophenidmethyl, thiobendazole, etc. And even among these limited options, fungicide like carbendazim, thiophenidmethyl, they have been banned by Government of India very recently in the month of May 2020. So now it is very much clear that we have to depend on the other option like your botanical and microbial pesticide and hygienic conditions like that. So there are a number of diseases like bed bubble disease, cobweb disease, yellow mold, brown cluster mold, bacterial blotch, false truffle, green mold, dry bubble, which are infecting our mushroom crop in the mushroom house. So when we talk about mushroom disease management, the very important thing is that what are the important source of inoculum, from where the source of pathogen that is coming out, or from where these different pathogen they are coming, like spent mushroom substrate and the substrate material which we use for compost preparation. These are among the important source of inoculum. Beside this, the material which we use for casing soil preparation, like your FIM and other coir with like material, they can also be act as a source of inoculum for mushroom diseases. And the infected food body, which are available in and around the mushroom house, they can also be a good source of inoculum. And beside that, generally in our mushroom unit, we do rainwater harvesting. And suppose if hygienic conditions are not there in and around our mushroom house, then with the flow of rainwater, the different dormant structure of our pathogen, they can come into the tank where we are harvesting the rain, that rainwater, and the water in our tank that become contaminated. And when we use that contaminated water for the irrigation purpose, the dormant structure or the dormant spore of the fungal pathogen or other pathogen, they become active when they come in contact with the host crop, and they will start infecting to that that particular crop. And among the other mode of transmission, insects are very important one, among the very important one option, like your flies, mite, they can be a very important carrier for different diseases of mushroom crops. And beside that, air can also be a very good source of transmission for different diseases. Suppose if the environment which is prevailing in the surrounding of our mushroom house is contaminated, and the source of contamination like your fungal spore and means seed of other pathogen of mushrooms, they can travel with the flow of air into our mushroom house, and they can infect our mushroom crop. Beside this, as we say that this casing soil is very important source for different pathogen, casing soil. So this is because when we prepare casing soil, if we do not bother much about the sterilization process of casing soil, then the different pathogen or mushroom, they will not be killed during the process of sterilization. And when we put that casing soil on our colonized compost, our mushroom fruit body will be infected by the different pathogen. Then one more mode of transmission, that is your picker's hand. Suppose there are few fruit body in the mushroom house which are infected, and when we go for harvesting of a different mushroom crop, and when we pick that infected fruit body, and with the same hand if we are harvesting the healthy fruit body and touching the healthy mushroom bag or bed, then that bag or bed will also be get infected. Now I want to tell you that there are some important factors which are required and important for the development of diseases, and by using those parameter, any major disease of mushroom, they can destroy our mushroom crop. And among those parameters, like your favorable environment, virulent pathogen, and susceptible plant or mushroom, and time, because it is not possible for every pathogen of our mushroom crop to infect all the mushroom crop, and it cannot infect at any time, because for the development of disease, there is a requirement of standard environmental condition, because the environment should be favorable, host should be susceptible, and your pathogen should be aggressive and virulent. Only then we can say that there is a maximum chances that a disease will establish in the host. So we have to consider these parameters also, and we have to maintain the environment as per the requirement of our host, so that we can provide strength to our mushroom crops. Mushroom diseases can be categorized into fungal, bacterial, and viral diseases. And for the identification purpose, we need to know the important practical keys by using which we can say that the disease which has appeared in our mushroom house is a fungal, bacterial, or viral. In case of fungal disease, fungus always produce sporulation on the surface of a infected crop, and because of that, the infected surface that become rough. So by using this key, we can identify the fungal infection generally. So second one is bacterial. In case of bacterial pathogen, they always cause oozing, and because of oozing, the infected host become slimy. And by using this key, we can identify the bacterial infection. In case of viral infection, the virus infection in all the agriculture crops, it cause color changes. Like in case of mushroom crop, generally Agaricus bisporus is stain are of white color, and due to viral infection, the color of those white stain can turn into brownish. So, and it may be that the infected host or infected mushroom fruit body, it become very leathery as compared to your healthy mushroom. And the growth of infected mushroom in case of viral infection, it will be very stunted, and it may be that the cap of the infected mushroom fruit body, it become tilted in position. So like that, these are the some important key. By using those, we can identify the different categories of mushroom diseases. So now we will come to our main business, the diseases of mushroom, and we will discuss first about the fungal diseases of mushroom crops. Bed bubble disease, it is caused by a fungus Mycobacterium perniciosa. And I tell you that this is the most serious disease among all the diseases of white button mushroom and other mushroom crop all over the world. And as far as the symptoms of this disease are concerned, the infected fruit body, it become fully deformed, and we can say that formation of a sclerodermoid masses, and the stipe become thick. And for the knowledge of everyone or all the growers, I tell you that suppose the mushroom fruit body, or suppose that our host, if it is infected at the early stage, at the time of peanut formation, then there will be no differentiation of this fruit body into different part like your stipe and head. It will become round, shriveled, and fully just like callous mass formation of the fruit body. And suppose if the infection occurs at mature stage, then the pathogen, it will target to the stipe. At the basal portion of the stipe will become very thickened. So like that, this way we can identify the infection of a bed bubble disease. And important thing about bed bubble disease is that the mycelial stage of Agaricus bisporus is resistant to bed bubble infection. Mycobacterium perniciosa cannot infect the Agaricus bisporus at the mycelial stage. So under the severe cases, there is a huge sporulation at the host surface, and when the sporulation will occur, then there in the surrounding environment also the number of spore will be available there, and the cycle of this pathogen will be continued, and the spore from the infected fruit body, they will come in the contact with the healthy fruit body, and again the infection will be there in the mushroom bed or mushroom house. And then the important thing about is the management of bed bubble disease. First is, we should follow the good agriculture practices. We should know what are the requirement of our mushroom crop which we are cultivating in the mushroom house. We should know each and everything about that crop. And suppose anyhow the disease is appearing in the mushroom house, then what we have to do? We have to be as early as possible to find out the infected fruit bodies. That is very important. And suppose if you are finding any infected fruit body in the mushroom house, then we have to wear gloves, and we have to carry the common salt that is required actually for the management of a bed bubble disease. Then we have to remove that infected fruit body, and we need to put that in infected fruit body in the carry bag or in the bag, and then we need to put some pinches of common salt at the place from where we have removed that infected fruit body. And be careful that we need not to put the salt on the healthy area, otherwise that salt will kill the Agaricus bisporus mycelium also, or the pinning also from the mushroom bag. So this you have to keep in mind then while performing this practice in the mushroom house. And other options are there, like your microbial formulation which are commercially available in the market, like alkaligen based formulation, bacillus based formulation, and neem based formulation, which are also very effective. What we have to be very early as possible, and we have to apply all the microbial and botanical pesticide preventively, because they will be very much effective when we use it before the occurrence of infection in the mushroom house. And in case of infected and healthy fruit body, there will be a clear cut differentiation between healthy and infected fruit body. Healthy fruit body will be very easily will be differentiated from the infected fruit body, because it will be the infected fruit body, it will be totally shrinked and it will be just like callus type of formation. There are some botanicals available in the market, like the combination of rice and cactus plant, like your praval. The trade name for combination of one of the combination of rice and aponcia combination is your praval, and that botanical pesticide can be applied in the casing soil at the rate of 1 ml per liter, and it is very effective against bitter bubble disease. One more option we have, that is Dorisom, is a combination or the extract of Pongamia glabra species, Pongamia species, and this is also effective, but we have to apply it before the occurrence of infection in the mushroom bag and beds. Another important disease is dry bubble. When our food body is infected with dry bubble disease, there is a formation of pimple type growth on the mushroom head. And the most common symptom of dry bubble disease, because this is a fungal disease, it causes localized and sunken lesions on the mushroom cap. And under severe condition, there will be a formation of cracks on the stipe of the infected fruit body. And for the management, we need to follow the good agriculture practices. And important thing about this disease is that we have to properly pasteurize the compost and casing soil, because the source of inoculum for this disease, the causal organism, that is Lysanicinum, is there in the substrate and the casing material. And for one more thing is that for the management of dry bubble disease is that we have to go for the scheduled irrigation. That is very much important. And another fungal disease, that is cobweb disease, it is very important in button crop as well as in the oyster crop. And as far as the symptom of this disease are concerned, there will be a formation of patches of mycelium on the surface of casing soil when we talk about button mushroom, and later on that mycelium will infect the fruit body, and initially it will cause infection at the stipe formation. Later on, when the mycelium will become mature and sporulation will be there, then cap spotting will be there on the button mushroom crop. In case of your oyster mushroom crop, the oyster fruit body, they will be completely covered by the white mycelium of the cobweb disease. So important thing about this disease is that the mycelial stage of this disease is very susceptible to the low humidity conditions. So important thing for the management of this disease is that we have to maintain the relative humidity in the room as per the requirement of your mushroom crop. Only then you will be able to manage this disease very easily. And we have to identify the mycelium of this disease as early as possible, so that we can maintain the appropriate parameters, growth parameter, as per the requirement of our crop. And other thing is that because this disease, the pathogen cause huge sporulation. Number of spore, billion, trillions of spore will be there inside the mushroom house. And those spore are very hardy. They can survive even under high temperature conditions, and they can survive for the longer duration if we do not take any necessary action for the removal of those spore. So we have to follow the proper pasteurization and post-cookout procedure. That this procedure we will discuss later on when I will conclude this session. So accordingly, we can manage this disease, but we have to identify it as early as possible so that we can take the necessary action. Another one important disease is green mold. This disease is caused by Trichoderma species, and it is very important in case of spawn. During spawn preparation also, this disease can appear in the spawn preparation bags, and it also infect your mushroom crops in the mushroom house. White button mushroom and your oyster mushroom and other medicinal mushroom like your Ganoderma, shiitake, all mushroom are susceptible for this green mold. And what are the prerequisite for the green mold under mushroom cultivation? When we prepare compost or substrate for any mushroom crop, suppose we are not bothered about the level of the pH which we are keeping at the time of compost and substrate preparation. Suppose we are keeping our that pH level of the compost acidic. We are not keeping as the pH level as per the requirement of our mushroom, because we have to maintain the pH in the alkaline condition, like 7.2 to 7.8, like that. What we are keeping the pH level in the acidic range, like 6.2, 6.2, 5, 6, like that we are maintaining the pH. So that type of environment is very much favorable for the Trichoderma development. Trichoderma, the mycelium of the Trichoderma fungus is very much similar to your Agaricus bisporus. And why do we call it as green mold? Because at the time of sporulation, in case of Trichoderma, the color of spores of this disease, this pathogen, is of green color. So because of green color of the spore, this disease is called as green mold. And under huge sporulation condition, when the spores start traveling through the air and start landing on the surface of mushroom caps, they start producing the capping. So we have to be, for the management of this disease, we have to particular about the compost preparation, substrate preparation procedure, and we have to consider all those parameters like moisture, pH, nitrogen, etc. into consideration, so that we can avoid the infection of the green mold in our mushroom crop. The botanicals or other microbial pesticides and the neem extract, particularly I will mention, it is particularly it is effective against this disease. Then another fungal disease is your Falstaffel. Falstaffel, the symptoms of Falstaffel, it will appear as a small, wrinkled, rounded, and irregular fungal mass on the casing surface. And what are the important things, because important factors which are responsible for the occurrence of Falstaffel in the in our mushroom house? That's the temperature during spawn is very important, most important parameter. If we are keeping that temperature of our room during the spawn stage above 26 degrees Celsius, suppose we are keeping the temperature 27, 28, 9, 30 degrees Celsius, and this high temperature range is particularly is very congenial for the development of a Falstaffel. That type of condition, they will activate the spores of Tellomyces, the causal organism of Falstaffel, and they will food body formation of Falstaffel will be there in the mushroom house. Another parameter is that, suppose if we prepare the compost on open field, then certainly there will be a prominent chances of occurrence of Falstaffel, because when we prepare the compost on open field, then the temperature profile will not be uniform, especially at the lower side of your pile. The temperature will be very less, and suppose if it is between 30 to 40 degrees Celsius, again that will also promote, that will also activate the spores of Tellomyces, and that will result in the infection of Falstaffel in the mushroom house. So I have already told you about the reason of appearance of Falstaffel in the mushroom house and how we can prevent. Like your, we should prepare the compost on the concrete surface and we should properly pasteurize and condition our compost. And we have to be particular about the environmental condition, especially temperature during the sporan stage. And for the management, we have to be very early. Suppose if any truffle is has appeared in the mushroom bag bed, then we have to remove that truffle from the mushroom bag bed as early as possible. And under severe cases, we can apply formalin at a low concentration, that is 2 ml per liter of water in the casing soil. That will help us in the management of a false truffle. And one more mold and disease, that is your olive green mold. It also affect the mushroom production because it appear during the sporan stage. During the sporan stage, sometime what happen, very odd smell is coming out from the growing bag, which is an indication of olive green mold. And after that, there will be a formation. There is a formation of a dark green or olive green color patches of fungal growth on the surface of the compost bag. And if we remove the polythene from that surface, there will be a granular structure of the causal organism of olive green mold, that is your chytomium. And what are the important reason for the occurrence of this disease in the mushroom bed or mushroom bags? Imbalance in the nitrogen source, and most important one is the your improper pasteurization and conditioning. We can blame the compost preparation process if this disease is appearing in the mushroom bag. So this way, and for the management, we have to be particular about the nitrogen source, and we have to be particular about the pasteurization and conditioning process of your our compost. Only then we can avoid the infection of this disease. And the people or the grower who are preparing compost by using long method of composting, they have to be very particular about the temperature profile so that we will be able to maintain the population of beneficial microbes in our mushroom compost. And the next important disease is your brown plaster mold. Brown plaster mold, this disease can appear during sporan and after even putting the casing layer on the bags, and it appear as a white color mat on the compost and on the casing surface. Later on, when the sporulation takes place, the color of that infected surface, it will become brown color. Because of that, it is known as brown plaster mold. And what are the possible cause or important reason why because of which it appear in the in our mushroom cultivation? Gypsum content is very important, because the greasy conditions it favors the development of a Populospora, the causal organism of a brown plaster mold. If the moisture content of your compost is high, suppose we are not taking care of a water content when we are preparing compost, then suddenly the moisture content of your compost will be very high, and your compost will be very comparatively greasy. And besides that, if we are not taking care of the quantity of gypsum which we are adding in the compost, suppose we are reducing the quantity of gypsum than the recommended one. So if we are adding less quantity of gypsum in the compost, that will make your compost very greasy, and which is a important factor for the development of a brown plaster mold. So for the management, quite simple. We do not add the less quantity of gypsum in the compost. We have to quantify, we have to add the optimum quantity of gypsum in the compost, so that your compost become of a good quality, and your the moisture content of your compost should be proper, so that Populospora do not get the favorable condition for its development. Another disease is yellow mold. There are 3-4 genera like your Mycophthora which are associated with this disease, and the characteristic symptom of this disease are like circular white colonies formation on the surface of bed and bags, polythene on the surface of polythene. So why it is called as yellow mold? Initially the color of the colony will be white, and later on when the sporulation of the causal organism will take place, then it will become yellow, and because of that it is known as a yellow mold. And the important factors which are responsible for the development of this disease are improperly pasteurized and pasteurized compost, and the compost which is deficient in the phosphorus. Phosphorus is considered as very important factor for the development of yellow mold pathogen. So suppose if the compost is deficient in the phosphorus, because the production scientists, whatever recommendation they have given, you have to prepare the compost as per that composition only. Otherwise, there will be some problem of different important nutrients like your phosphorus. And for the management of this, you have to properly pasteurize the compost. You need not to prepare the compost on the open field. And suppose if it is regularly occurring in your mushroom house, then what you can do, you can add 1 gram per kg of compost of single super phosphate when we are doing a spawning for a button mushroom crop, and it will help in reducing the incidence of this disease. Suppose if it is appearing in the later stage when the mushroom is coming up, and even at that time also this single super phosphate can be added by drenching 1 gram per liter of water. You can prepare solution accordingly, and you can drench your that casing soil, but you have to keep in mind the level of moisture. Another mold is your Cepedonium yellow. Cepedonium yellow is purely it is related to it is a problem related to your chicken manure. So when we use chicken manure as a source of nitrogen, then we have to be very particular about the pasteurization process. Otherwise, there will be a prominent chances of occurrence of this mold. And Cepedonium yellow, it also produces some circular colonies on the infected surface. What the colonies of Cepedonium is spongy, like it is different from the colonies which are produced by the yellow mold of white button mushroom. So, and important thing about this disease is that so the people who are preparing compost by using long method of composting, we do not recommend for them to add chicken manure as a nitrogen source. And people, those who are doing this compost pasteurization by using tunnel method or preparing compost by sod method of composting, for them it is for them there will be no problem. They can use it as a nitrogen source. What they have to be very particular about the killing temperature and conditioning process of the compost. Ink cap are very common disease in the mushroom cultivation. It infect button mushroom. It can infect your oyster also. And what type of symptom it produce? It produce a food body with long stipe and short pileus. And if you press the pileus of those long stipe food body, there will be oozing of ink from that cap. Because of that, it is called as ink cap. And why do it appear in the mushroom house? It is when there will be imbalance in the nitrogen dose. When we add more nitrogen, and we are not doing the conditioning of your compost properly, and ammonia gas is there in trapped form in our compost, and water content or moisture content is also high of your compost, then certainly there will be the in cap, it will appear in your mushroom house and it will deteriorate the quality of your mushrooms. And it can appear in the sporan stage also if compost is not properly prepared, and we have to be very particular about the removal of these food body of in cap as early as possible. Suppose if the food body of in cap, if it is open, then it will release number of spores in the air, and those spores, they will infect the healthy food body of button mushroom and the mushroom which you are cultivating in the mushroom house. So this way we can manage this in cap disease also. Now we will talk about those people who are doing spawn preparation or those who are having this spawn laboratory. So for them, I would like to advise that don't take lightly all the contaminants. When we do culturing, there will be a number of contaminants in the media plate. So we have to discard those plates. We have to discard that media of plate properly. We have to prepare. We have to wear proper kit, apron, gloves, goggle, mask, etc. to avoid the exposure to those harmful contaminants like your Aspergillus niger, Aspergillus flavus, because these type of contaminants, they produce aflatoxin, which are very harmful for human being. So we have to be very particular. We have to protect ourselves and we have to protect our assistants also. Now, second category of diseases, that is bacterial diseases. Under this, we will talk about bacterial blotch and bacillus species in the spawn. Bacterial blotch is very much common under mushroom cultivation, especially your white button and oyster mushroom. In my introductory part, I told you about the categories of different diseases, and during that time I told you that what type of symptoms are produced by the bacterial pathogen. I told that bacteria always cause oozing, and in case of button mushroom, you can see the symptom of bacterial blotch. There will be yellowing of infected food bodies of white button mushroom, and the infected food body, it will be very slimy. When you touch that infected surface, that will be very slimy due to oozing or the toxin tolacin produced by the causal organism Pseudomonas tolesi. And the severely infected food body, there will be a formation of cracking on the stipe, and that it will peel off. So these type of symptoms are produced by the Pseudomonas and bacterial blotch on the button mushroom. In case of oyster mushroom, suppose we are cultivating white color, creamy colored strain of oyster in our mushroom house, sometime what happened, those white color strain, they will become yellow, and later on they will become very slimy, and sometime because of oozing, oyster of different color, that become very slimy, and their growth it become very stunted. So this type of symptoms are produced by the bacterial pathogen. And for the management of bacterial pathogen, when we talk about mushroom cultivation, then we certainly this thing come in our mind that mushroom is a fungus, so we have to maintain the relative humidity as high as possible. So that we this type of thing is coming in our mind, and we start maintaining high level of humidity by creating very misty atmosphere and excessive humidity we are maintaining in the mushroom house. And this is not required actually. We have to maintain 85, maximum 90% relative humidity, because excess humidity when we maintain in the mushroom house, and suppose after condensation droplets are coming down and resting on the mushroom surface for longer duration, like 5 to 6 hours, then these type of conditions are very favorable for the development of a bacterial infection. So we have to maintain the optimum relative humidity. We need not to create that excess relative humidity or misty atmosphere in the mushroom house. And suppose bacterial infection has occurred in our mushroom house, then what we have to do? We can apply calcium chloride, 1 gram per liter water, and suppose if it is not available, we can use some amount of bleaching powder also in the same 1 gram per liter. And this calcium chloride, when we use this calcium chloride on our mushroom crop, it will protect our crop from the bacterial infection, and at the same time it will also make our food body more shiny and white as compared to the untreated one. So this way we can protect our crop from the bacterial infection. Then the bacillus species in the spawn. Sometime, you know what happened when we purchase spawn from any source, or when we prepare master spawn at our own in our own spawn laboratory, then sometime, you know what happened in the inoculated bottles, light green color liquid oozing is there, and very sour and foul smell is coming out from those bottles, which is an indication of a bacillus infection. And what are the possible reason? The reason for bacillus infection in the spawn bottle are like when we use the already infected grains or very old grain we are, wheat grain we are using for spawn preparation, and that grain of very old grain we are using, moistened one we are using, poor quality grain when we are using. So then chances, prominent chances will be there for the occurrence of bacillus infection. And how we can avoid the bacillus infection in our spawn bottles? What we can do suppose we have wheat grain, so we have to wash those wheat grain by using bleaching powder, 1 to 2 gram per liter of water, and after means washing with the bleaching powder solution, thereafter we need to wash those grain with the plain water. Then we can use it for boiling and the further autoclaving process, and then we can use it for the inoculation also. And suppose if we don't have this bleaching powder and other material, then what we can do, we can give the soaking period for the grains. We can put the wheat grain in the free water for 5 to 6 hours. And by doing so, we can activate the endospores or the spore of bacillus, which are dormant on the wheat grains. And activated bacillus spores can be killed very easily by the autoclaving process. And if those spores are not activated, then it will be hard for the autoclaving process to kill those bacillus spores. So this way we can clean our wheat grain, and then we can utilize those grain for the spawn preparation, and we can prevent the infection of a bacillus. Suppose bacillus infection is there in the master culture, then we have to reject that lot, and we do not take that master spawn for the further multiplication if there is any indication of a bacillus infection. And then after that, the third category of our disease, mushroom diseases, are viral diseases, and some disorders also there. Sometimes we correlate those disorders with the viral diseases. Among those, then long stemmated mushrooms. Sometimes, you know what happened when we are cultivating mushroom, the length of the fruit body is very large. And what are the possible reasons for that increased length of the type of the fruit body is the high CO2 concentration. Because we are not, if we are not introducing fresh air in the at the right time, and if there is a suffocated atmosphere in the mushroom house and very high concentration of CO2 is there in the mushroom house, then that type of environment, it will increase the length of fruit body, and your PLS will also start leaving the stipend, and the quality of those produce will totally deteriorated, will be totally deteriorated, and even the local consumer and your that owner of canning unit, they will not accept that type of material, and growers, they can face huge loss from that type of disorders. So for the management, we have to maintain the optimum level of CO2 concentration during fruiting, and as per the requirement of our strain of that particular mushroom. Then hollow core and brown pith. Suppose if we have not prepared proper schedule for the irrigation in our mushroom house, and moisture and our crop is going under moisture stress condition, then the inner portion of our stipe, it will become very it will become dry and it will become hollow. And suppose the moisture level of casing soil is quite low, then it will produce very prominent symptom of a hollow nature of your stipe in the mushroom house. So for the management, we have to go for the scheduled irrigation to avoid the moisture stress. Then crocodile and scales. Suppose we are giving fresh air, very frequently we are giving fresh air in the room, and what we have no provision for maintaining the relative humidity, and by introducing excess air in the room, we are reducing the relative humidity of the room, and under very low relative humidity, there will be an injury on the food body surface, and the food body will become brownish in color, and the quality of those type of strain will be totally deteriorated, and they will be of no market use. So you have to maintain the desirable level of relative humidity. You have to be very particular while introducing the fresh air, and you have to fix some means provision for the maintenance of a relative humidity. And one more thing is your mass spinning. You know, sometime what happen when the spawn is over, and your fungus has fully colonized the substrate, and we have put the casing soil on the surface of the fully colonized bag and bed, and then what? Somehow we have no idea that how much caseron should be there after putting the case. And if we are introducing fresh air and reducing temperature immediately after casing, or at 5-10% of caseron, then you know what happened when we'll reduce the temperature and when we will introduce fresh air at this very low level of caseron, you know what happened? That mycelium, it will start producing pinhead, and as our that mycelium is at very low level and inside the polythene and below that casing soil, then pinhead formation will be there. Primordia will start, fungus will start producing primordia at that level only, and because when the primordia has no space to grow, that will start drying. That will start drying because of non-availability of space, and no food body formation will be there. So for the management, we have to be very particular about each and every stage of crop, and we should know at what time, at what level we have to reduce CO2, at what time we have to give fresh air to our mushroom house, in our mushroom room, to produce the fruit bodies. So only then we can prevent this type of thing from the happening in this type of disorder in our mushroom house. Then mushroom X disease. Mushroom X disease, these diseases are not very much common in India so far, because we have the number of surveys in the different mushroom growing area, and on very few occasions we have detected the infection of viral diseases. And for the information of different growers and I want to tell that what are the symptoms which are produced by the mushroom virus X disease. When the viral infection takes place in the mushroom house, then the full body growth, it will become stunted, and as I told earlier, that viral infection, it causes color changes. The white color stain, they will turn into brown color, and the texture, it will become leathery, and maybe there will be the early opening of the pileus, and the position of the pileus on the stipe that may also change due to the viral infection. So for the management, we have to be very particular about the source of spawn. We have to purchase the spawn from certified source. And suppose we have detected any symptom virus in our mushroom house, then certainly we have to worry about the vectors of different diseases like or fly, mice, etc. And suppose we have detected, then we have to keep that a room or bed in the from isolation. And when it is confirmed that it is virus, it is a viral infection, then we can discard that. Otherwise, that infection will spread by a different mode of a transmission. So, and finally, I want to tell to all the growers some tips for the disease management under mushroom cultivation. Whereas this good agriculture practice, as I told earlier, that this is very important. Suppose we are planning to cultivate any mushroom cross, we need to know all the figure and facts about that particular crop, so that we can maintain the growing growth parameters as per the requirement of that crop. And for the management of disease, when we harvest any crop, when we take any crop from the mushroom house, the pH of the substrate, it go down actually. When any fungus produce food body by utilizing the nutrient from the substrate, the pH level of that compost, it will go down. And to bring that level to the desirable level, we need to apply calcium carbonate, 1 gram per liter of water on the casing surface. And suppose we are taking 2-3 flushes, then after each flush, we need to apply calcium chloride, 1 gram per liter, to avoid the bacterial infection. And the most important thing is that when our crop is over, and when we think that now we have to terminate the crop, so after that, we have to be very particular about the room sterilization. Because suppose if we have that control unit and control room facility, then we need to go for the post crop cookout process. That is, we need to maintain the temperature of the room above 70 degrees Celsius for 3 to 4 hours minimum. And that process will kill each and every contaminants from your room, and it will make the room disease free. And suppose we don't have that controlled facility, and we are growing mushroom at very low level, and we are doing cereal cultivation under low cost mushroom huts, then we can apply formalin at 2%, and we need to close the room of those room huts for at least minimum for 3 to 4 days. Only that process will help us in sterilizing our growing room. So these type of things are very important, very basic about each and every crop. We have to be particular about the growing condition, temperature, pH, etc. Whatever crop is there, we are planning to do. So in the end, I would like to say one more thing is that mushroom diseases are just like our teacher. When we will do any mistake during your spawn preparation, during your compost preparation, and during your crop management period, then certainly one out of all the diseases, they will appear, disease will appear just to warn you that something wrong you have done. So you need to take all these diseases as your teacher, and you have to prepare yourself accordingly so that you can maintain the conditions and parameters of compost, casing soil as per the requirement of mushroom cultivation. So it's all about from my side. So I wish you good luck for the mushroom cultivation. Thank you so much.